Is it visible now?
Yeah, yeah.
So today I try to take some portions related to nonlinear dynamics and then going to bifurcation, the chaos, and then different types of manifolds. And if time permits, then some case study that how to solve it. Basically, yesterday we discussed about the stability or different types of dynamical systems. But what are the tools or techniques we use to analyze the nonlinear system? Because for dynamical system, if it is a linear system, either by a differential equation, we are getting the closed system solutions. But when we are talking about the nonlinear differential equation, then to find out the solution and to solve is a difficult process. So sometimes we got a closed solution, but normally we are using the simulation processes to find out the solution. So there are the different tools, phase plane method. Yesterday also we discussed a little bit about the phase plane method. Today we will discuss. Then we have a bifurcation diagram, then Poincaré maps, then double Poincaré map, reduction to one dimensional maps, Lipnov exponents, and fractal dimensions. So all are not possible, but I will try to take today in details about the bifurcations and different types of the bifurcation, how we have to measure it, and then goes to the further for the explanation of this. And maybe tomorrow we will take the Lipnov one. And the last one is chaos. I don't think that up to chaos we reach, but I will try to link something with the chaos. So how we have to identify the chaotic systems or any system? So basically, if any system is a nonlinear system or it exhibits the properties of a nonlinear, then it may have the chaotic behavior. Linear system can never exhibit the chaotic behavior because that has a controlled one. It means this is a linear, but nonlinearity is our one tool to move towards the chaotic systems. If you have a random inputs, then also you have the chances to get a randomness or a chaotic system because it does not respond in a deterministic system. Then also there is a, if there is a change with time and you got a periodic solutions, then this means you are getting a closed forms. If non-periodicity you are getting, then it may lead towards the chaos. Then you have a point systems or the fractals. Then the limit cycles. Yesterday I showed some limit cycles. And in general, whenever you are getting a three limit cycles, then it leads towards the chaos. One limit cycle or two limit cycle is normally a stable or the marginable stable structures. Fourier spectrum. When there is the appearance of the broad spectrum of the frequencies in the output, then there is the chance of getting a chaotic motion. Because if the spectrum is going on increasing, then there is the signal is randomly moving in that one. Now we are getting a Poincaré maps. As yesterday I told you that Poincaré is the plot between a time and the distance of that, or the, you can say the set of points xtn with respect to tn is called a Poincaré map. If tn is one period, this means then orbit consists only of one point. If it is two period, it consists of two points. If it is a three period, then chaos occurs. So in case of chaos, the Poincaré map will consist of neither finite set of points nor a closed set of points. Self-similarity is also leading towards the chaos. So roots for finding the chaos is variation of parameters. Normally we do this whenever we have the parameters. And yesterday also I showed you that by controlling the parameter, or I will show you the different phases when the parameter, and if you are changing the different parameters, then it may lead to the chaotic motions. Period doubling, that I will try to cover it. In this phenomena, basically it is changing from one point to the another one, and so on. When you have the period doubling phenomena, it tends towards the, its value is, critical value is 4.669. After that, it becomes a chaotic system. Then there is a quasi-periodic systems. So in quasi-periodics, if you have a ratio of the frequencies, then if it is not commensurable or periodic, then if ratio is irrational, then there are the chances of the chaotic motions. Same way, if we are getting, yesterday we discussed a lot about the fixed point. If we are getting a stable fixed point, then it is called an attractor. And attractor means if you are having a strange attractor, then it may lead towards the chaotic situation. So whenever you have an unstable sets or a marginable stable, then there are the chances to move towards the chaotic points. This is the KM theorem. Also through double resonance. In case of resonance, if double resonance, then it may lead to chaos. In case of KM theorems, if the perturbation grows and the system is growing with the perturbation, and surfaces start disintegrating, then we may lead towards the chaotic system. Now I'm starting with the basically the main role in the nonlinear system is the iterative functions. Because whatever functions we are taking, you are iterated that. And with computer, because in a computational dynamics or in that, we are using mostly the iterated function. So what is iteration or what is iterated functions? Suppose we start with a function x square plus constant, and we start with some seed x naught. So now we are doing the iteration. This means iteration means x1 is x0 square plus constant, x2 is x1 square plus constant, and like this thing. So our goal is to find out what is the state of this orbit, means whatever iterations we are doing. So this means with the time tn is there, and we are trying to find out the orbit of xtn. So if we are able to trace that and find out that, then we are able to find out that which kind of the system we are getting it. Now I'm taking a very simple example. Suppose we start with the x square plus one with the seed zero, and all we know that it is a simple process. When you're putting x as zero, then the first iteration is one. If we are putting x1 as one, then it is two. If we are putting x1 as 2, so it comes to be 5. If we are putting x1 as 5, it comes to be 26. If we are putting x1 as 26, means this one x4 as 26, so it comes to be a big number, which is 677. If you are putting 677, then it comes to be roughly around 458,330. So you see that in the sixth iteration, with a simple function x square plus one with seed zero, you're getting a number as a 458,330. So if I ask the seventh number, so of course it comes to be the very bigger number. And if I ask that what is the orbit of this, or where this trajectory goes to be. So of course the orbit of this tends to infinity. This is a very beautiful definition given by James Gillick, that in the mind's eye, because we cannot visualize the infinity. But seeing of infinity, this is the way of seeing the infinity, that you can analyze that what is the infinity. We are taking the similar example, x square plus 0, the starting is seed 0, then initially it is 0, first one is also 0, second is again 0, third is again 0. So whatever number of iteration you are taking, it goes to the 0. So if I ask that, what is that one? So it is clearly a fixed point because it is moving towards the 0. So I think yesterday, whatever we did, I tried to explain the same thing with this form also, that with time, how the values are changing and how you will be able to find out. So if you are getting a fixed point, this means it is a stable equilibrium point. Same if you take x square minus 1 with the seed 0. So it is 0 minus 1. If you are putting minus 1, you got 0. If you got 0, then it is minus 1. Like this thing, this means it is oscillating between 0 and minus 1. So you are getting a two cycles. One is around 0 and one is around minus 1. Yesterday, I showed you the example of a dumping oscillator. So you got this type of the cycle. If you have this example, this is a very beautiful, only x square minus 1.1, and see that you are putting a seed as 0. So in the first case, 0, then minus 1.1, then 0.11. Now substitute this value. So it is taking a time to calculate that. Now see the this example and the earlier one. Earlier one is x square minus 1. And this is x square minus 1.1. So see that both the curves are totally having a different behavior. So in general, iterative function, suppose function is z square minus 1. Initial value you are taking as minus 1. So f square means the second value or iteration value of this is 0. So this means nth value you are getting minus 1 and 0 if n is odd and even. Same means I showed you earlier also. Now I'm taking this as a complex one. And see that if you have a z square plus iota with seed 0, if you start with 0, so z1 is iota, z2 is minus 1 plus iota, z3 is minus iota, and like this thing. So it is moving around these two. I will show you. We start with the 0. So initially 0. When you are putting 0, it goes to iota, means 1, 0. Sorry, 0, 1. When you put iota, then it is minus 1 plus iota, so minus 1, 1. When you are putting minus 1 plus iota, it comes to be minus iota, 0 minus 1. Now onward, if you are doing any iteration, it is only around these two points. So either this blue point or around this red point. So all these iterations are around these. So you are getting a cycle, one here and one here. So it is showing you the two cycle. Now how to find out these ones? Basically, this is a function which I showed you. So left hand side is x and right hand side is x square plus 1, which you are taking. And basically Mandelbrot tried to diagram or to figure out this function using the IBM computer in 1975. And when you are putting 1 on this side, right hand side, you are getting like 1, so left is 2, like this thing. And you see the figure of this. Only I'm giving you the glimpses. This is the picture which you are getting as x equal to x square plus c. And the beauty of this curve, if you see that, it is not a closed curve. Inside, as you are going, you are getting the another picture of the similar type. See that figure. So Mandelbrot set is basically xt plus 1 equal to xt square plus c, where c is the some imaginary number. Here we have taken iota, suppose. And starting with x0, so you, I showed you that is iota 0, then iota, then minus 1 plus iota, then minus iota. If point is convergent, then it is inside of the set. If it is not, then it goes to the outside of the set. So this is a Mandelbrot set, basically. This is a real axis and the imaginary axis. See that how it is, beautifully it is. And this is a table. If you see that initially, if you have 0 point, so you get all the points as 0. So it is convergent in Mandelbrot set. If you're taking 1, then it is 0, 1, 2, 5, like this thing. Then it is divergent. If you have taken minus 1, then it is 0, minus 1. It is oscillating. Minus 2, again it is convergent. Like this thing, we are plotting it. And this is the Mandelbrot, which he got a picture. And this now known as a Mandelbrot set. And the beauty of this set is if you are zooming inside of this set, because this is not a closed curve. Anywhere it is not a closed, it is remains open. And when you are going inside or zooming inside of that, you're getting a similar structure. Just see that. This is just to visualize, to analyze that how beautiful are the nonlinear structures can be. This is the structure. Now, if you are zooming inside of this yellow sheet, you are getting this structure. And if you are zooming inside of that, you're getting this structure. See how beautiful structures are these ones. And this structure, when you are again zooming in, you're getting this thing. See that inside again and again, you are getting the similar structures. Mathematically, it is known as a fractal. So inside of, again, you are getting a similar structure. So any complicated structure can be analyzed using the similar structures. And in the universe, you can say that whenever any kind of the disaster is there, so we can say that order is inside the chaos. So this is the proof that always you are getting a life within a system or the disaster situations. So now we are coming to the different types of the models or this, what we are taking here. Time series, Poincaré sections, phase space, Lipnov exponent, bifurcation. Time series, when we are talking about that, it is a series of data points which is indexed or listed or graphed in the time order. Time series are very frequently plotted via line chart. All of you have done in your earlier classes also. And it is important because nowadays we are dealing with a big data analysis, signal processing. So all are sort of a time series. So any kind of analysis based on these are the time series analysis. So time series are used in statistics. Earlier, now we are dealing with the signal processing, pattern recognition, econometrics, financial mathematics, weather forecasting, and we have used this fractal method and the different combination of the model methods to analyze the Indian weather, on which I got that weather prediction award. So that gives you the more accurate result. And nowadays, you see that our forecast for the weather is almost a correct approximation. Same way for earthquake prediction, ECG, EEG, and control engineering, astronomy, you name any branch of the science, you can use the time series. And now the complete big data analysis are based on these time series. Stochastic model for a time series will generally reflect the fact that the observation, how is close together in time and how they are changing apart. Now I'm taking a simple example. Yesterday also I have taken, but that yesterday I only give you the glimpses. Now suppose you have a continuous system. system is dx by dt is ax plus dy, and dy by dt equal to cy plus dx. Now in this system, you see that a, b, c, d are the variable constant. Now if as I am changing the value of a, b, c, d, then you are getting a different type of the time series, and see that the patterns also. If I am taking a as a minus 6, b as minus 8, c as 5, and d as 6. And when you are plotting the time series, so first case is dx by dt is minus 6x minus 8y, dy by dt is equal to 5y plus 6x. And when you are plotting this same time series for x and y, keeping time, is this is a time and these both are the x and y series. You see the here the colors also. Green one is the y series and blue one is the x series. See that both the series have some disturbance or moving something, but after some times both are tending towards the zero. This means this is the regular case. It is moving towards the fixed point, which is a zero. Now come to this series, second phase. Here a is minus 6, b is minus 8 as earlier there. D is also 6. This means a, b, d, I kept constant, only varied the c. Here c is 5. Here we took the c as 6. When you are taking c as 6, you are getting this type of the behavior. Both the series are having this structure. So these are means making a, I can say a intermittency state, or a, they are making a node. Means they are not coming to the point, but they are making a, or moving around that point. So it is making a node type of the structure. Now when you are coming to the last one, in this case, when we are taking it, so you see that here a is the minus 6, only we are taking c as 3 and d is 9. So see both the series. This is also changing with time, and the blue one is also changing with time. And both the cases, if you see that it is not having a structures like these ones. That you are not able to find out which where they are merging or they are converging to. So this has the randomness, or you can say a chaotic behavior of that. Then if you are looking for the point time series, now we are coming to the phase space. Yesterday I also discussed about the phase space. So in dynamical system theory, it is a space in which all possible state of a system are represented with each other corresponding to the corresponding with all systems are possible, or the you are able to plot that. So system is evolving over time, and we are plotting them as a time, as a x and a x dot. So if you are saying that, and then how these are changing with the initial conditions. Now I'm taking again the similar example, ax plus by and cy plus dx, same of a equal to minus 6, b equal to minus 8, c equal to 5, and d equal to 6 in the one case, first case. So here what you are doing, you are plotting between a x and y. When you are plotting between a x and y, then you see that you are getting a this stable structure. This is a stable one. So this is the point where it is moving on. But when you are taking a equal to minus 6 and p equal to minus 8 and this structure of this one, and try to plot between x and y, nothing is there, simple x and y, because this is a curve in x and y. As x varies, what is the value of y you are getting it? Then you are getting here as this intermittent state, and which is a form of a, yesterday also we saw that it is a limit cycles or a tractor or a node. So you are getting around a point, but you are getting you are not approaching towards that point, but around of that, you are in the neighborhood of that, you are grasping the positions of that. So it is a node or an intermittent state. But when you are coming to the last state, you see that if you want to plot any point or locate this point, so this is very difficult. So this is a chaotic state or a randomness, because here you are not able to point out the point where it is moving in. Now if we are discussing about of the stability of the system, so there are the two methods to discuss the stability, and these are the Lipnow method. First method is linearization. Yesterday also I gave some idea about the linearization. So, but now I am going in much detail that how we have to do the linearization of any system. So, if you have a system, so for examining the stability of nonlinear system, as we are yesterday also I said that we try to transform the nonlinear system into the linearized form, and then we are trying to find out whether we are getting a stability of the system. Hello. The first step for this is a linearization. Suppose any function is given. So if a function is given, we are expanding that function about the initial point. So if you are expanding a function about the fixed point or initial point, then you are expanding it for using the Taylor series. Now you see that a function is, you are expanding about x bar, which is a fixed point. So you are getting this type of the structure. Now different orders are there. So up to which order you are taking it, it is important, and which is giving you approximations of the errors. So this is a Taylor expansion. Now if I have to linearize it, what we are doing, we are neglecting the higher order terms. So if I am neglecting the second order and higher order terms, so this goes away and I have only this function. So now I have a linearized system, which is fx equal to around a fixed point f value plus partial derivative of that function. So this is now a linearized function. So this means we are expanding the function about the fixed point. Then we are linearizing the system, and then we are trying to find out the stability of the system. So for equilibrium, as I said yesterday also we discussed, we have to take the derivative equal to zero. So this means dx by dt is fx, which is zero. So this means you are getting this function is zero, or partial derivative is zero. So if it is zero, you are getting this point, or this is zero. So original system is this, linearized system is now this one, and using this yesterday we got the Jacobian one. So this gives you the Jacobian structures, which you are using as the DF as this, or this is the Jacobian structure. So this is the original, and this is around that fixed point. So what we are doing now, any system is given, we are equating that is system equal to zero. Once we are getting a points, then using the Jacobian, we are finding a points around that point. Now you see this example, and simple y dot or function of y is y minus 1 into y plus 1. This means the function is y square minus 1. And now we plotted it as a phase plot. This is a phase plot. So it is a phase plot means you have a function, means a y, and y dot curve is known as a phase portrait. So this is the phase portrait of between y and y dot. If you plot this thing, So this is a sort of a parabola because y square minus 1. So center is at minus 1 and you got a this parabola, means this is the origin. And now if you see the curve, as you are moving here, you are equating it 0. So what points, 2 points you are getting? Y is 1 and minus 1 are the 2 points. So this is a 1 point and this is a minus 1 point. Now we have to check the behavior, what kind of the velocity or structures we are getting it. If you are moving from y minus 2 towards that. So this means here, when you are having a minus 1 point, you are getting it as a stable fixed point. But when you are getting it as a 1, so you are getting unstable fixed point. How you are getting it? Simple, this curve is this. Take the partial derivative, find out the eigenvalues, eigenvectors, and then try to find out this thing. So when you are calculating it and substitute y equal to minus 1 neighborhood, so this is a negative structure you are getting it. That's why it is coming you to be total 1 is negative. So it is showing you the fixed point. But if you have a y equal to 1 in the neighborhood of that, so in the neighborhood of y equal to minus 1, if you are coming from here or here, both sides you are getting its structure as a negative 1. You see that here you are getting it as a negative 1. But when you are moving in the neighborhood of 1, you see in this neighborhood, so you have 1 is the negative, but here it is changing the position to the positive 1. So that's why the function here is a positive 1. And that's why it is an unstable fixed point. So this means the two fixed points which you are getting here, 1 and minus 1. So one is a stable point and another one is an unstable point. And now I'm taking a case of a simple pendulum. Yesterday I gave you this example. So if you have a simple pendulum, all we have studied in our earlier classes. So our function is phi double dot plus g by l sine phi equal to 0, where mg sine theta is the gravitational force, l is the length of the thread of the pendulum, and so omega naught square is defined as g by alpha. So you're getting this system, which is a phi double dot plus omega naught square psi phi equal to 0. So this is a representation of a differential equation of a pendulum. Now, if I'm putting it, yesterday also I took that theta dot is omega. So omega dot equal to minus omega naught square into sine phi. Now, when you are equating them as zero, so you see that if you're putting this value as, now here are the different values. You see that a different type of the basins you are getting it. Between here you see minus 1 and minus 2. It is showing a hyperbolic forms. So it is a basins of attractions. And when you are coming to the here, it is again the same thing, and these are known as a separatrix. And yesterday I showed you these have a node points or the elliptic forms of these ones. So you see that. So up to this portion, you have a elliptic or node points, but after that you are getting a, it is as a divergent, or you can say as a system is a chaotic one. Now see that I will show you the different positions. If you have phi naught is 0 degree, means the initial value is 0 degree of the angle. So you are getting this point, which is a fixed point. And of course it is a stable one. But if you are taking 45 degree, so see that it is making a rotation about that, and that rotation is a elliptic form. As you, yesterday we got it as a x dot by a plus y dot by v omega va whole square equal to 1. So you are getting this ellipse. If phi naught is 90, still stable, and you are getting a means a more wider ellipse. If phi naught is 135, You see that still you are getting a elliptic, but it is more widened ones. Now come to 170. Again, it is the same thing, but wider in a ellipse. Now, if you see the change, if you are coming across to the pi angle and comes to 190 degree, then here now you are not getting a ellipse forms. You are getting only a one dimensional or one side of this the structure. See this. So you are getting only a not a repeated cycles. So it is going only like this thing here. Only on the one side you are getting it. Same way when you have a 220 degree, it is more speedily you are getting it. But when you are at a 180 degree, you are getting a upward direction and that is a unstable fixed point. So see that zero is a stable fixed point. 180 degrees are a stable fixed point. Between zero to 180, you are getting a marginable stable or a nodes point. But after 180, you are getting a different basis. Now I'm going backside. So you see this one. So this is a structure between here, you are getting as a node points. And after that, you are getting here are the these points where you are getting those are unstable onwards as a basins. So now when we are coming to the systems, this is another example. If you have a system as x1 dot equal to x1 square plus x2 square minus 1 and x2 dot equal to x1 minus x2. Now we have to check the stability of the system. So these are the two functions. So what we have to do for finding the stable or fixed point, we have to equate them as zero. So equate it equal to zero. So when you are equating it zero, from here you are getting x1 equal to x2. When you are substituting this value here, you are getting 2x1 square equal to 1. So this means x1 is plus minus 1 by root 2. So your point are either both are positive 1 by root 2 or both are negative 1 by root 2. So now you got the two fixed points and our purpose is to find out what kind of the behavior of these ones. So of course, when you are taking a Jacobian for Jacobian partial derivative 2x1, 2x2, 1 and minus 1. So this is the Jacobian 2x1, 2x2, 1 and minus 1. When you are solving it, at this point, Jacobian is this. So when you are solving this, then the eigenvalues comes out to be these ones. So here there are two eigenvalues you are getting, which are different in nature. Means one is a positive and the another one is a negative. But because yesterday I said if you have a different type of the behavior of the eigenvalues, so here the system is unstable. But when you are getting at this point minus 1 by root 2, then you are getting a value as a this one. And here it is a complex one. And in complex, yesterday I gave you that if you have a real part as a negative one, then you are having a stable system. So in this case, because real part is negative, so you are getting a system as a stable here. So for this example, you got the two points. And one is a unstable point and the another is a stable point. Now we take the example of a pendulum again with the change in the harmonic oscillator form. Here we have it is a damped oscillator, we are taking it. The set of equation is x dot equal to v and v dot is changing where the damping force is proportional to the cube of the velocity. This means we are taking a damped oscillator, or you can say that a forced oscillator or a it is not a simple harmonic motion following. So this factor is here, which is creating a nonlinearity. So when you are solving it in the similar manner, y is this function. So your function is v and minus x minus mu v cube. When you are equating these equations zero, so v is zero and x is zero. So you are getting a fixed point as only origin. Now to check the behavior at origin, these are the systems which you got, Jacobian. So of course, Jacobian is what you are getting. This is the system. So in Jacobian, with respect to v is one, then zero, then minus, or you can say zero, one, minus one, and minus three mu v naught v square. So this is that. Now at a point zero zero, when you are calculating, so zero, one, because v is zero, so you got this point as a minus one zero, and when you are solving it, so you are getting a roots as plus minus iota. Yesterday we discussed about that whenever you have the only eigenvalues which are imaginary only, then we have to check the stability. So here we can't decide about the stability because these are changing. And now the value is because depending on the mu value here, this parameter. Now you see that if you are plotting a graph between x and v, these ones, if you are taking mu is 0.25, x1 is 2, and v0 is 0, then if you see that you are getting a curve is coming and this is converging here. And yesterday, one candidate asked me the question about that, what is our difference in node or stability or something marginable stable. Here, see, clearly see that. This is a point, it is moving like this thing, and it is coming to be this. This 0, 0 is a point which we have to check, but because it is not converging to 0, 0, it is in the neighborhood of 0, 0. So this is a node point. So it is, we can't say that it is neither stable nor it is unstable, but it is making a marginable stable. So node is your marginable stable because it is giving you the loop of that structures, that intermittence state. If you perturbed further, it may goes either to the stability point or it may goes out of that. So now, basically, what is required? Because first form, to here it is failed because we are not able to analyze using this as a function about the stability. So we are using the another tool, which is a Lipnov functions, and it is known as a second form of Lipnov function. What we are doing here, instead of misfinding the function, now we are trying to find out the energy. Earlier case, we have taken the phase spaces. So we discussed about stable points or fixed points. Then using phase plane, first Lipnov method, how to find out the stability of the system. Now this is the another form or second Lipnov form. Here we are trying to find out the energy around that point. And then we are trying to find out whether the system is a stable system or not. And as an energy concept, we know that energy remains the constant or it is neither created nor destroyed. Same here we are taking as in the damped harmonic oscillator. So we are looking from the point of energy. So the system is still losing energy, and sooner or later, it must stop at the equilibrium point. But because as you see earlier, it is started like this thing. Now it is moving as the particle or this oscillator removes, and means its energy will diminish. Same way it goes or falls to the 0 point. So principle of the second Lipschitz function is based on the, we have to find out the function Vx, which represents the energy or generalized energy, and we satisfy these conditions. First, the function V should be a continuous differentiable about the fixed point. It should be positive definite. I think all we have discussed a lot. So it should be a positive definite. This means Vx bar should be greater than 0 for all x in the neighborhood of that point. And Vx equal to 0. Second is the derivative of this function should be a negative definite. So see that what three conditions you are imposing. First is the function should be continuously differentiable. The function itself is positive definite, but its derivative which you are taking, it should be a negative definite. So if you are coming to this condition third, at in the neighborhood of this point, whenever dv by dt equal to 0, so this means you have to check whether dv by dt is less than 0 in the neighborhood of that point. If it is, then the function is stable. Now we are checking that example. So if we are taking a case of this harmonic oscillator, energy is nothing but it is 1 by 2 of kx square plus half of mv square. If you are taking k and m as 1, 1, so general energy is this function. Now we are creating a function as a Lipschitz function. So this is the function dE by dt is del E by del x into dx by dt plus del E by del V into dV by dt. So when you are taking out these partial derivatives, so this is x, this is V, and then dV by dt and all these, you know that earlier equation. Because x dot is v, so dx by dt is v. dv by dt is minus x minus mu v cube. So you have this one function. Now I try to find out this function. So dE by dt is, comes out to be del E by del x means x. Dx by dt is v. I think you can calculate also. Xv and plus v of minus x minus mu cube v cube. So these term cancel out, you got it as minus mu v4. This is a positive definite function itself. Here you are getting it as, or this is also continuous differentiable. This you are getting as negative. So all the three conditions are satisfied. Function is positive, function is continuously differentiable. It is positive definite and its derivative is negative definite. dE by dt is this. So we can notice that it is always negative, except of course at the point V equal to 0, where it is 0. So at the fixed point is 0, 0, you are getting all the three conditions that at the instant when the spring is maximally compressed, this one, at the instant where the spring is maximally extended. So first condition is clearly satisfying that it is a stable one. But if you are having a compressing or extension of these ones, in both the cases, you see that your dE by dt is remains to be less than 0. Because if you are compressing, so it is in the neighborhood of 0. If you are extending, then again, it is in the neighborhood of 0. And in the both cases, because this V4 is the even power, so you are getting this function as a, always as a negative function. So all the conditions are satisfied. So you are getting for damped oscillator, this 0.00 as a stable point. So I think I'm able to reply yesterday question answer that node is a stable point or not. It is a... because you are taking a node as a marginal one, so it is a stable, but it is depending on the conditions. And So using the Lipnov function, we are able to find out that it is a stable fixed point. Now we are coming, calculating the another form at the energy function. So basically, what is the energy function? X1 square plus X2 square plus like this thing. About the origin, we are getting this expansion. So this means if you are getting a in journal, this is the journal expansion. So we are taking a, because when you are differentiating this, you are getting this type of the form of the function. Now I'm taking another example of a damped pendulum. If you have this example, earlier we took up to this one. This is factor is not there. Now this factor is there. So phi double dot plus 2 to del of phi dot and like this thing. So equation is as earlier as these ones. Yesterday I showed you, but now I'm showing that how you are getting all the results. Now when you have this one, yesterday we tried to plot this and see the its graph. Now you see that this is the equation, theta dot is this one, another form is this one. So you have a points as theta omega and the function is omega and kl square sine theta over this one. So if you are taking it, this is zero. So when you are putting it zero, so omega is zero as well as this is zero. If this is zero, then there are the cases sine theta is zero or this is zero. Now if sine theta is zero, you are getting this case. And if this is, so cos theta equal to some value as a constant one. Now we are coming to the stability using this function as the perturbation theory or perturbed around that point, or you can say a linear realization. This is a function, this is an initial point, and around in this point, we are perturbing the system. So using the linearization of the Taylor's one, you got this structure. So this means if we rewrite, psi dot t is a of psi bar plus around that the function which we are taking it, where a is the Jacobian and which comes to be this function 0, 1, because your function is omega, so 0 and omega 1 and theta value is this one. So you are getting this value and omega is not there, so it is this 0. So this is the function. So see the difference in the earlier case, because it is dependent only on a directly on the theta. So you calculate it here. It is changing as a function of two, where sine and cosine both are there. So when you are taking a characteristic polynomial, you got this structure. And when you are putting it zero, so S is plus minus of this complete structure. So this means this is your two distinct eigenvalues. And as you are getting a two distinct eigenvalues, so now it is positive or negative, it depends on that value. So here you see these are the values. So there are the two cases if sine theta is zero. If sine theta is zero means this factor is not there, so you are getting this one. Sine theta is zero means theta is 0 degree. So your cos theta is 1, this is 1. So you are getting KL square by I, P by KL minus 1. Now, if this factor is a positive one, this means the roots of this comes to be then the positive ones. So if this is greater than 0, then there exists a positive eigenvalue with the positive parts. So this means there is no imaginary part is there. So in this case, because we are getting it as a positive root, so it is an unstable one. But if you are taking this as a negative, this means this is the imaginary part. So both eigenvalues are imaginary. And in this case, of course, earlier as we are checking it, the earlier case of the this experiment. So using this, you are getting this as a stable one, because then we have to use the second condition of the Lipnov one. And using this, because at this time you are getting both are imaginary values, so it shows you the stable condition. Now coming to the another one, if this is zero, then your point is plus minus sine theta naught and into this value. So in this case, there exists only one positive eigenvalue with positive real part, and since this is not zero, so there is a, in this case, because positive real part is there, so you got as a unstable system. And see that these are the points. This is your P star point. So in this domain, you are getting it as an unstable one. But in this domain around the pi, you are getting it as a stable point or zero point. You are getting it as a stable. But here it is, you are getting it as an unstable point. Now I'm coming to the bifurcation theory. I think that phase space, Hello, something? Now I'm coming to the bifurcation theory. So basically what is that? Actually a system is going to change or bifurcate. And that is an important phenomena. Because from which point the system is changing its structure. So mathematically, it is the change in the qualitative.
Hello.
Yes. Hello, ma'am. Aap Kriti Kumari. I just want.
Han. Bolo.
Yes, Kriti.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, ma'am. Huh? Actually, I just want to ask you how to calculate the Lyapunov generally, right? Suppose I have to take the assumption ki koi hame Lyapunov function consider karna hai. So it is not every time that we have to take it in the x1 square, x2 square.
I have not created it as a x1 square or x2 square. This is the actually, see that. I have not taken that as a x1 square or x2 square. It is the energy function which you are getting, which you are getting through a Hamilton's one, na? L equal to t minus 1, so kinetic energy and potential energy you are taking it. I have not taken it as a x square.
Yeah.
Okay. But ma'am, suppose I have to take it for general, suppose I have a system and I have to use Lyapunov. So we have to consider it. Is there any way to calculate, or it is a hidden trial kind of method?
No. If any system is given, basically, so you write down a Lagrange of that. Because that Hamiltonian I am not covering here. So firstly, you have to write down the Lagrangian function of that, which is depend on T and V. Okay. T means the kinetic energy and the potential energy. So you are writing a Lagrangian function of that. Then you are finding a Hamiltonian out of that, and which gives you the exactly as an energy function, as a transform of that. If you want in the next, directly how we are getting a Lipnov ones, that I will take in the next session. That is only based on the system, and then we are calculating. But for the system function, always for finding a Lipnov, you have to go to the Hamiltonian dynamics. So find out the Lagrangian system, differentiate with there as a generalized momenta. Because if you see, I am using a concept of that similar, because we are plotting graphs in distance and velocity. All my graphs are in distance and velocity. You see, na, phase spaces are in distance and velocity. So when you are plotting in distance and velocity, those are the phase space curves. And it is basically a representation of a phase space or a Poincaré space. When you are talking about phase space, means it is a generalized coordinate, which is your x-axis. And the y-axis is your generalized momenta or velocity. So Hamiltonian dynamics is about a about momenta and the general expansion. So Q and P is giving you the Lagrangian, and then find out the Hamiltonian, and directly you are getting this energy function. So basically this this is nothing but a kinetic energy, and this is the potential function which you are getting, and using this you are getting this energy as a sum of the energy.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am.
So now one way is that one. Another way is if we are not able to find out through that, so we are checking that how the topological structure is changing around that point. So then we are trying to find out whether which kind of the system it is. Because in nonlinear dynamics or nonlinear analysis, it is not so simple that by using one tool, we are able to analyze that. Like in the using the Lipner first function, we are not able to find out, but using the second structure, we are able to find out that yes, which kind of system it is. So bifurcation, if we are talking about, it is a sudden change in the behavior. Now you see that, and I try to put it as a simple. Simple, this is the curve. I will explain only here, then I will go experimentally how you are getting it. Now, this is a basically a logistic work. Main bhi isko plot bhi karke dikha dungi. Here you see up to this point. This point means up to 3. There is only a one system or one curve. But after this point 3, it is diverting into the two fields. So this means up to this point, so 0 to 3 means, if I am saying, it is having a one curve, but after that this curve is bifurcating into the two, which is showing here the period, this is the time in that. After that, here it is transforming to the 4. So this means every time it is changing the curve, and this structure, this is a chaotic structure. Because it is very random. Yes, slide mein baad mein leti. Pehle I am explaining this. Basically, there are the two principal classes of the bifurcation. One is a global bifurcation, which occurs when larger invariant set of systems collide with each other. So it is an equilibrium of the system. So global bifurcation mein abhi jo we discussed about the limit cycle, so collision of a limit cycle with the saddle point, or collision of a limit cycle with the node, or etc. So I think all those questions which has been asked yesterday, now you got the answer of those ones. And the another one is a local bifurcation. So it is like a maxima, like we are calculating a global maxima, global extreme or local extreme. The same way you have a global bifurcation and a local bifurcation. So if we are talking about the local bifurcation, so it is a sudden change in the nature of our fixed point or periodic point as we are changing the parameter. So fixed point may appear or disappear, changes the stability or even break into the periodic points. So such bifurcation can be analyzed through the local stability properties of equilibria or periodic orbits or other invariant sets. Now I'm taking a logistic equation. I think logistic equation is given by the Wernerst equation. So it is given for the population over time, and this is the logistic equation. And here xn is the actual population in the current year, xn plus 1 is the population in the next year, r is the combined rate for the reproduction or for the starvation, a zero value for the x mean means the population, and x equal to 1 means population on its limit. So this means population lies between 0 to 1. 0 means a catastrophe or about to die. one means it is the extreme limit, means the chaotic one. Means I'm not saying a chaotic one, but that is the upper limit of the population. So if we are taking this function, see that how simply I try to find out this one. Now in this function here, R and you want the two values. One is the parameter value of R and another value as the initial value of X naught. So now I took R as 0.5 and X naught as 0.5. So this means you are taking an initial value as 0.5 and parameter you are changing R as 0.5. So see that after some iterations, the population goes towards the zero. This means population dies out in this case. Now you come to R equal to 0.8. So here again, initial value is 0.5. But after, it took much longer time, but after some time it goes away. Now come to R equal to 1. Initial value is 0.5. It took much longer time, but also it took much longer years. But after that, again, this will die out. Now come to R equal to 1.5 with the population initial value as 0.5. Then you see that this population is not dying out, but it is converging towards 0.33. So after that, it is converging to 0.33. Now if R is 1.5, but initial value is changed 0.2, then again it is converging to 0.33. If R is 2.5, initial value is 0.5, then this value is converging towards 0.6. This means population exists here. Now come to R equal to 3.2. See the changes. Initial value is 0.5. And you see that curve is going towards either 0.8 or 0.51. 0.7995 or 0.5129. And like this thing. So see that after these, it is converging either to 0.7995 or 0.5130. This means here at R equal to 3.2, the curve is bifurcating to two parts. One is either 0.7995 or 0.5130. Now move further. If R is 3.5, then it is moving to 4 points. Now come 3.55. So it is moving to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is moving to 8 points. See, this is the structure. If R is less than 1, as you see here, if R is less than 1 from here, the population dies out. So if R is less than 1, this is the the system dies, or this is the case of the extinction. If you are coming to the between 1 to 3, then it is a fixed point area because you have, it is tending to a single value at any initial value of X naught. See here, up to 1, it is dies out. Between 1 to 3, you see that it is tending towards a single value. So then you have a 3 to 3.57, it is oscillating. So if you have R is 3.2, it is moving towards the 2 points, then like this thing. So you see that here it bifurcates to 2, then 2 to 4, 4 to 8, like this thing. So between 3 to 3.57, it is having a two or more discrete states, and between 3.57 to 4, you have a dyschaotic region. But you see, if you see that inside of that, there are the white windows also. So here you are again getting a solutions. So it is not that once chaos start, that completely it will be a chaotic situation. Again, you are getting a system or the stable system inside of that. So for higher values of R greater than 4, all solution tends to infinity. And so after that, it is useless model. So basic is this one. Here it is a doubling of this one. Now you see that this is the structure which you have. So your any, and that was a population model, but this is a tumor growth model. cell is divided into two parts, 2 to 4 structure, 4 to 8, and like this thing. So this is also in the cell division, you have this structure. So for the tumor treatment, basically you see that how in a 4th or 5th iteration, how complicated a structure you are getting it. So if you have two doctors to treat the tumor, so that's why it is said that in the initial stage, it is easy to cure, because whatever branch you are cutting, suppose this branch cut it. So in the next session, this only grows, this and this grows. This is not there. So, but if you are doing at this stage, so there is the growth levels are there. So it is important that doctor should know at what point of the which node they have to tackle that. Suppose they are tackling here, so there is no use. But if they are tackling here, this means this complete goes out. So it is very important to handle the chemotherapy sessions with the utmost care, because that is the point which growth cannot be sustained. If it cuts here, then if this cuts, so this is not there, complete one. If it is somewhere here, then this cell is there. So this is the tumor growth model of the similar structure, whatever you see that. And our lungs also has this property. You see that they also has the similar structures. And that's why the capacity of lungs is very important, or the increase. See, this is the structure, which is how complicated this growth is there. So that's why if it is not cutted at a particular point, then it is creating a structure problem. So if it is cutted here, so then their growth model is not there. If it is here, then accordingly. In our body, our neurons also has this structure of the growth of those. That's why the cells are growing. And it is a similar structure throughout our body. And that is the reason within a fraction of second, signal transform from brain to any part of our body. Same, this is a lungs of, you see that how the branches are there, or the dividing into these ones. See easily. Now we are coming to the different types of the local bifurcations. These are the 5 types of the local bifurcation. Saddle node or fold bifurcation. Then the period doubling or flip bifurcation. Then pitchfork bifurcation. Then transcritical bifurcation and the hop bifurcation. I try to keep as simple. So first is in this bifurcation, basically two fixed points collide and then annihilate each other. Suppose we have the differential equation of the system as dx by dt equal to r plus x square. If you are putting this as 0, for r less than 0, when you are putting equilibrium point is x square equal to minus r. So if r is negative, this means you are getting these points. But if r is positive, then no real point. So if r is less than 1, so you are getting these 2 points. This means one branch is here, another is here. After that, these 2 are annihilating each other. So this is a first kind of bifurcation. Now I'm taking another example. I think easily now you are able to find out x1 is 0. From here, x2 is plus minus root 2. So points are your fixed point is 0 root 2 and 0 minus root 2. Now see that. This is a Jacobian matrix. Minus 1, 0, 0, 2x2. At these points, if you are calculating, this is the structure of this. So eigenvalues are minus 1 and 2 root 2. both are the negative and positive. So it is a saddle point. So there are variation in sign. And for the another month, these are the two eigenvalues, which are both are negative. So it is a fixed point or a tracking node. So what is the bifurcation? This means you are getting a two types of the point. One is the saddle and the another is the node one. So see this one. This is the structure of this one. So this means saddle node bifurcation is a example for dx by dt equal to r minus x square. So you got this type of the bifurcation. Now the another one is this type of bifurcation. अभी लॉजिस्टिक में कर देखा है इन डिटेल्स. सो हेयर यू आर गेटिंग अ पीरियड डबलिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स. नाउ सपोज यू हैव अनदर वन फेस व्हिच इज आर एक्स माइनस एक्स क्यूब. सो व्हेन यू आर इक्वेटिंग इट एज जीरो, सो यू आर गेटिंग एज एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो एज वेल एज एक्स स्क्वायर इक्वल टू आर. सो यू आर गेटिंग फॉर आर लेस देन जीरो there is just one stable fixed point at zero, but for r greater than zero, when r is greater than zero, if you are putting it as zero, so x square is r, so x is plus minus root r. Now you see that first point is x equal to zero, so this one, another one is plus minus root r, so these are the two bifurcations. So this and then these two points. So this is the case of the another bifurcation. Now another example, if you have rx plus x cube, so you have r greater than 0, this is the x equal to 0, and if r is less than 0, then you are getting, yeah, Dr. Jyoti, something you want to know, Dr. Jyoti? For r less than 0, there are the two unstable fixed point, which is plus minus minus root r. So you see that this one and then this one also. So this one, and it is the another case of this one. So it is a superficial of on the own cases. Now the another example is rx minus x square. So easily, I think you are able to try these type of the problems. So if you have the rx minus x square, so x is 0 and x equal to r. So for r less than 0, you are getting x equal to 0 and x equal to r. For r greater than 0, again, one is unstable at x equal to 0 and stable at x equal to r. So you see that this one and this one, another one is this one and this one. So another case is like if you have a two dimensional system. So dx by is this and dx2 by dt is these ones. Now we are finding the differential equation. When you are equating this is zero and equating this is zero, you are getting only one fixed point, which is 0, 0. And when you are finding a Jacobian of this, it comes out to be, yeah, Mukesh. You want to ask Mukesh?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So when you are taking a Jacobian of this, it comes to be R minus 3 of x1 square minus x2 square, like this thing, and then with respect to x2, this is the derivative here with respect to x1. So 1 minus 2x1 x2 with respect to x2 is this derivative. Now when you are solving it at this point 0, 0, so it is r minus 1, 1 and r. Now, when you are solving or finding its determinant, I mean, eigenvalue, so you are getting this as a characteristic equation, and which gives you the two roots. So this means those two roots are r plus minus iota. Now we have to see the behavior of this. If r is less than zero, because you have a real part as r and the imaginary part as a iota, means this one. So if a real part is negative, so always we are getting a stable fixed point. But if r is positive, we are getting an unstable fixed point. So again, if we are not able to find out if r is zero, so you are getting two complex structures. So we have to use the Lipnov function, which is simple x1 square plus x2 square in this case. And again, this is, we are not taking as a journal, we are finding it. Okay. So in this case, you are getting this structure. So at r equal to zero, because dv by dt is outside the fixed point. So it is always negative. Hence, this function is a fixed point. So Lipnov is stable and also asymptotically stable. So this means the function which I have considered for r less than and equal to zero, we are getting a stable fixed point. But for r greater than zero, we are getting it as an unstable fixed point. And you see that it is the phase plot of this thing. So it starts here and coming towards this point. And here, this is a node point, this is a stable point. So this is asymptotically stable point. And this is for r equal to plus one. So it is not coming to that point. So see the difference in all the three cases. And this is the, that it is moving out. Because r is positive and x naught is, it is going out of the diagram. So it is a last case, which is a case of, so it is a stable fixed point, asymptotically stable. This is asymptotically stable, and but this is showing you the unstable point. And this is the 3D view of this one. All the limit cycles. So you see that it is coming, it is coming, it is coming, and here you are going out of that. Now for the continuous system, if local bifurcation appears when eigenvalue has zero real part. If the eigenvalue is zero, then there is a saddle point. So we are getting either the Pitchcock or transcritical bifurcation. If eigenvalues have zero real part, but they are complex conjugate, then there is a Hopf bifurcation. So now we are coming to be that. And in case of discrete system, a local bifurcation appears when the modulus of eigenvalue is equal to one. If the eigenvalue is plus one, then there is a saddle node, Pitchcock or critical bifurcation. If eigenvalue is minus one, then there is a feather doubling bifurcation. If there are two complex conjugate eigenvalues, but modulus equal to one, then there is again a Hopf bifurcation. So in both the cases, you see the conditions for continuous system as well as for the discrete system. And these are the all examples. If your real part means this one, you got saddle node, transcritical or Pitchcock bifurcations, either continuous or discrete dynamical system, feather doubling bifurcation for discrete dynamical system here, if lambda is minus one, this one, and here it is a Hopf bifurcation. Now I'm coming to the example of this one, y dot equal to y square plus mu. As mu is changing, if mu is less than zero, you got this structure, which is giving you the stable, this is a stable point. If mu is equal to zero, so this is a parabola. If mu is greater than zero, you are getting this structure. So if you see that this is a stable and unstable structures. So here you have an unstable, but only in this case, we are getting a stable structures, but all are double phenomena. So bifurcation is there. Same way if you are taking this example, earlier I have taken this one. So it is mu of mu minus y. So it is, if mu is less than, you got this one. Mu equal to zero, mu greater than zero. So here you have a stable structures, but these are the unstable zones. So you have this one, and this is unstable. See that. Earlier also you see that you got this as a, this structure. Earlier also I showed this is a stable and this is unstable structure. And in this case, this is a stable structure, but this one is an unstable one. So this is a transcritical bifurcation. Now we have a supercritical ones. Already I showed you the example. If mu is less than zero, you have this one. If mu is equal to zero, you have this curve. Mu greater than zero, you have this curve. So you see that it is coming stable and bifurcating to these two. Or another one is stable and this is an unstable one. So this is that one, and then after that R is the plus minus one. R. I'm sorry. Just a minute. So you have a all type of the systems. Subcritical or Pitchcock bifurcation. You see, this is the example. So here only this one is a stable one. Other these are the unstable forms. Already all I have shown in the different examples. Yesterday also we took this example of a Duffing oscillator. So this is a Duffing oscillator, and here, if you are equating it as zero, so you got y is zero, and when y is zero, here you are getting x is zero. So your point is these ones are the when q is system, so q is zero. So this point is not there since y is zero. So you have these two points: x is zero or x equal to plus minus one. So your points are minus one zero, one zero, and zero zero, and when k is between these, so m and n are stable and saddle points. And this is already I showed yesterday also. When q is 0.2, so only one oscillator is there, which is a period one. When q is 0.28, so there are the two cycles of period 4π/ω. When q is 0.29, there are the four cycles. When q equal to 0.37, so five cycles, and like the different type of the cycles observed. And this shows the bifurcation diagram for q between 0 to 0.45 of the Duffing oscillator. So it starts, these are the two branches, then they merge, and then these are the, again, these are transform of this. So see that how beautiful these are the bifurcation diagram of the Duffing oscillator. Now, what is the meaning of chaos basically? Actually, dictionary meaning of chaos is disordered, formless matter supposed to have exist before the ordered universe, or complete disorder or utter confusion. Physically, it is a periodic long-term behavior in a deterministic system that exhibits sensitive dependence on the initial conditions. And a periodic long-term term behavior means the two trajectories which are started together with a small change, they are not settled to the similar structure. So it has a irregular behavior, of course, non-linearity is there, sensitive dependence on the initial condition. This means, like I have shown you the example, two trajectories started very close, one is moving apart from each other. So this is the case I will take in the next session about the, this is a Lipnov exponent. If you have a Lipnov exponents which are positive, then you are getting a chaotic systems. Now we are coming to a one-dimensional system. Suppose a map is defined xn plus 1 equal to fxn. So linear system, it is axn plus b, where a and b are constant. So this is the example, logistic map of PKI. Then we are coming to the logistic map for nonlinear. It is mu x into 1 minus x, and mu is lies between 0 to 4, because after 4, you see that there is no population because it tends towards the infinity. Same way, if you are taking a biological population as x dot equal to bx minus cx square, b is the birth rate, c is the death rate. So it is again an example of a logistic map. Now we are coming to that, how we are to explore that. If mu is 0.8 and x naught is 0. So you see the curve, mu is 0.8, x naught is 0.7. Choose initial condition, forced vertically until you hit. This is the very good example. I'm showing you that how to make the curve web. Now here you started from this point, take where it meets to the curve. Once it meets to the curve, then proceed horizontally where it will hit to the line y equal to x. Okay, then again go down and try to meet at the function where it is curve, and then again like this. I am showing you in details. This is the evolution of the logistic map, that how you are getting a fixed point. You see that here, you see that you are moving to the curve, then take a straight line, then again move to the curve, then take a straight line, then move to the curve. So you see that you are moving towards this point zero, which is a fixed point. But come here, in this case, here you have taken from this point curve, then this line, then curve, then this line. So this means then fifth curve, then this line, then curve, then this line. So this is a fixed point here. Now here you come. In this case, this, then this one, then this, then this one, then this, then this one, then this one. So here you are getting a two points which are merging. One is here, one is here. So this is a two cycle you are getting. And when you are coming here, see that it is a chaotic situation. You are not able to, because you are getting a multiple points where it is meeting to the curves. So these are all the analysis which are analyzed using a cobweb. This is called the cobweb or the jala, makadika jala diagrams. So easily all the evolution you can see that. So in the first case, if you are seeing, you see that this is the point. In the second case, you see that it is moving like this. So this is the point. So condition for the existence of this is logistic map is given when you are equating zero. So this is the point, or this is the point. Here, if mu is greater than one, so this is less than one. So the existence of this is depends on this factor. Stability already we discussed. Also for logistic maps, this should be less than one. Already I showed you earlier that the derivative should be less than one, then only you are getting that it is a stable logistic map. So if function is this one, it is less than one. Fixed point is attractor for mu less than one. Second fixed point is attractor between mu to three. And otherwise you have a transcritical bifurcation. You see this is, so first case here, another is here. But in between you have a bifurcation processes. Between 3 to 4, already I showed that how you are getting a different cases. And this is all our same one. You just repeat it. I think in your tutorials, you try to form these type of the structures. So see that here you are getting like this one. In this case, it is continuous. So it is a node case. So two cycles, one is this one and one is this one. So see, either curve is here or curve is here. Same way, if you are taking this one example, here d is greater than zero. So this means you are getting a Phillips bifurcation. Function is this one, x1 is this one. Derivatives, when you are taking a root, it comes out to be these ones. So where do points appears? You see that here the value of comes out to be 3.449, which shows you the chaotic situation. So here you are getting a bifurcation to four cycles. As earlier also you see that. So it is not so easy to calculate each and every steps. Only you are processing analytically as well as computationally too. So these are all clear structures which I have taken it. When you have here, it is a fixed point here. Then you are coming to this one. These are the two points. When you are coming here, again, these are the two points. When you are coming here, in this point, you see that how many points you are getting it. I think easily you are able to visualize whatever I have taken the first structure. Similarly, so in finite series of period doubling, so you are getting Pitchcock bifurcation. After point 3.56, chaos appears. And in general, there is a stable structures up to this, then the period doubling and period continuous for that. And this is the complete structure. And this is the Feigenbaum constant, which already I have shown it, that where period doubling bifurcation start. So delta is limit k tends to infinity, mu k minus 1, divided by mu k plus 1 minus mu k. Means it is the change between the two bifurcations. Means where, so if you are taking, it tends to 4.669. And this number is known as a Feigenbaum constant. So if delta tends to this one, then always you are getting a chaotic structure. So on these lines, there is a delta values this one. And I think it is because sensitive to initial conditions. Already I showed you this one. Now if you are taking a general structure of the map xn plus 1 equal to f of xn, like this one, or this one. So how we have to do the cobweb diagram? Already I showed you, you start with the curve, then to line, then to 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 curve, like this thing. If you are getting, this is known as a cobweb. And if you are getting a particular point, then you are getting a fixed point there. So you see that at the complete analysis, you go straight, then here, then here, then here, like this thing. So here at 0.something here, I think 0.8, you are getting it as a fixed point. Similar different structures, you can create that. I think you can do this exercise during your tutorial classes. Use either the MATLAB or Mathematica, any software to draw these diagrams. See that how beautifully you can generate it. Here you are getting a two points. So all these are already I showed here. Here all these are the four values, which are 3.45. Here these are the two values. Here these are the eight values. And here, so these are the Feigenbaum constant for this one. One is 4.669, and these are the example of, you see that it is again showing you the Mandelbrot sets. So double repetition, then again repetition, then a chaotic situation, and this white strip shows you again the order out of that. So all these are the structures which you are getting through these structures, and this is the structure where it is called a Feigenbaum constant in this case. Now we are coming to the, this is a very good example, and this is known as a Lorentz detector. Here we have three differential equations. Delta is the ratio of the viscosity. Basically, Lorentz is studying this model, and he tried to create a mathematical model for the atmosphere for weather prediction. So what he did, in a cylindrical box filled by air, which was heated at the bottom, and then he cooled from above, and then he put all the condition and put this diagram. amidst this equation. And to surprise, he put this system into the computer and left that. And after one day when he came back, he got a so surprised result. So he was surprised. And that's why the structure which is got is known as a Lorentz detector. So what he got, when he is using the values of the parameter delta equal to 10, r equal to 28, and beta equal to minus 8/3, then he got a Lorentz structure. And these are the time series structure of these ones, all these ones. So blue curves are related to the initial condition for 10, red curves are for 10.01. Now see that both are the initial condition, initial really very close to each other, but see the difference in the structures. They are not coming to the same structure. R is 10 and 10.01 are having a different behaviors. And this is a Lorentz detector which he got at. It is also known as owl eyes. All these are the different ones. And this is a bifurcation diagram for this. So see that one structure is bifurcating to all. Here, all bifurcated transform towards the one. So these are the set of equations which Lorentz took. Put that equal to zero, this means y equal to x. Since y equal to x, so here you are getting solving these. So these are the conditions. So one critical point or the point is fixed point is 0, 0, 0. Another is this one, and the third one is this one. Since he took the values as r equal to this and beta equal to this, so you are getting these points as this one. Should I continue?
Ma'am, still there are 10, 12 minutes. If you wish.
So should I continue or manifolds yesterday, tomorrow I will take?
Okay, any participants?
I will. Any questions? If some questions are there, firstly, I will answer that.
You can ask participants any questions? Because she has to start the new topic, which will not be covered in this 10 minutes.
Yeah, that's why.
So it's better to start next time. So if you have any questions, anyways, ma'am, your presentation was really very intensive. Of course, we would like to have this presentation at the end of your lecture series. It is participants' request also that
you
like.
I will share. I will share you everything.
Because otherwise, it is just now. There's just a beginning. We need.
This one I'm not taking because I just want to show them that everything. Don't take it as a. You see that in our now embedded systems or whatever in communication we are using, these are the simple nonlinear structures which we are using there.
Okay.
So basically, think globally instead of locally.
Yes.
So this is a simple example which I want to show that everywhere you got a structures of these. So don't think that only nonlinear dynamics we are doing, because everywhere, whether it is a weather phenomena or a signal analysis or traffic computer something. Or any domain, everywhere your importance is there. Only you have to think widely or think globally, and keep your that wherever you stuck out with the equation, try to apply your mathematics there. So I think this is also a map of the different combination. And now in the search of your Google or anything, again, you are using this type of the structures. So these are the models I'm not taking right now in these ones because it is a lengthy. So I think this is all about. I can show you 1 or 2 minutes are there. Started my career as a working in celestial mechanics and dynamical astronomy. Also recently I'm a visiting associate of Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics. So here we are using satellite motions. So in satellite motions also we are using the perturbation theory. So I'm not going in much detail, but this is a satellite which is revolving about the Earth, and there are the different type of the forces, means the perturbation or torque forces, and the solving this means in this case we are taking a aerodynamic torque. We got this equation and see that how complicated this nonlinear equation it is. And whatever we have done or showed you, using this, we have plotted this. This is a time series. Okay. See all the time series plots. Then the phase space plots are there. And see the behavior or dynamics is changing. It is stable to unstable. It is changing. And see that. Here also you see that. So it is easy to analyze this thing that as you are changing the values of the parameters, how different trajectories you are getting. It is a marginable stable. This is a chaotic totally. This is you are getting a regular behavior like this thing. All these are the, whatever I did today on all are based on these ones. So this only I want to show that how this is the bifurcation ones, how you are getting a bifurcated. These are also the bifurcation. So this is a transcritical bifurcation. See all these ones. This is a Poincare maps. So see that this is a regular and this is a chaotic ones. So now I think it is more than enough now today.
Yeah, this is mathematical modeling process. The cycle.
Yeah, that is. I tried to, but I am not taking. Tomorrow I will take this.
Yeah, sure, ma'am.